and continue with the fragmentation yesterday what we have seen. So whatever is a datagram, when it is fragmented, each fragment has its own header with most of the fields repeated, but some have been changed. A fragmented datagram may itself be fragmented if it encounters a network with an even smaller MTU. So whatever is a datagram, it may be fragmented several times before it reaches the final destination. So a datagram can be fragmented by the source host or any router in the path. So when it travels from source to destination, there are number of routers in the path. So the datagram can be fragmented by the source host or any router in the path. Reassembly of the datagram is done only by the destination host. Because each fragment becomes an independent datagram, whereas the fragmented datagram can travel through different routes and can never control or guarantee which route a fragmented datagram may take. So the fragmented datagram can travel through different routes and can never control or guarantee which route a fragmented datagram may take, as all of the fragments belong to same datagram should finally arrive at the destination host. Reassembly must be done at the final destination. By fragmentation, we mean that the payload of the IP datagram is fragmented. So when we say a talk of fragmentation, the payload of the IP datagram is fragmented. However, most parts of the header, with the exception of small options, must be copied by all fragments. So most part of the header, with the exception of some options, must be copied by all fragments. Host or router that fragments a datagram must change the value of three fields. So whatever is a host or router that fragments a datagram must change the values of three fields. Which are those three fields? Fields are flags, fragmentation offset, total length. Rest of the fields must be copied as they are. So the value of the checksum must be recalculated regardless of fragmentation. Then fields related to fragmentation. So three fields in an IP datagram are related to fragmentation: identification, flags, and fragmentation. So the identification, which is of 16 bit, identifies a datagram originating from the source host. Then combination of the identification and source IP address must uniquely define a datagram as it leaves the source host. Then whatever is the IP protocol, it will make use of a counter to label the datagrams in order to guarantee uniqueness. Then this counter is initialized to a positive number. Then when the IP protocol sends a datagram, it copies the current value of the counter to the identification fields and then increments that counter by 1. So what happens when the IP protocol sends a datagram? It copies the current value of the counter to the identification fields and increments the counter by 1. As long as the counter is kept in main memory, uniqueness is guaranteed. So whatever is a value in the identification field, it is copied into all fragments. Then all fragments have the same identification number, which is also the same as original datagram. This identification number helps the destination in reassembling the datagram. All fragments having the same identification value should be assembled into one datagram. So all fragments which I told you, all fragments will have the same identification number, which is same as the original datagram. This identification number helps the destination in reassembling the datagram. All fragments having the same identification value should be assembled into one datagram. 3-bit flag fields which define three flags. So we'll see 3-bit flags field which define three flags. Leftmost bit is reserved, not used. Second bit, which has been shown with red, darkening with red one. So it is leftmost bit which is reserved, not used. You can see this left diagram. Second bit is D bit, which is D means do not fragment bit. And if the value of this do not fragment bit is 1, the machine must not fragment the datagram. Then if it cannot pass the datagram through any available physical network, then it discards the datagram and sends an ICMP error message to the source host. If D is 0 value, the datagram can be fragmented if necessary. Third bit is M bit. What is that M bit? Means more fragment bit. If its value is 1, it means the datagram is not the last fragment. There are more fragments after this one. If its value is 0, it means this is last or only fragment. Then the 13-bit fragmentation offset field shows the relative position of this fragment with respect to whole datagram. It is the offset of the data in the original datagram measured in units of 8 bytes. So the 13-bit fragmentation offset field shows the relative position of this fragment with respect to whole datagram. It is offset of the data in the original datagram measured in units of 8 bytes. Datagram with a data size of 4000 bytes fragmented into 3 fragments. So datagram with a data size of 4000 bytes fragmented into 3 fragments. Bytes. Original datagram are numbered 0 to 3999. So original datagram are numbered 0 to 3999. First fragment carries bytes 0 to 1399. First fragment carries 0 to 1399. Offset for this datagram is 0 by 8, which is 0. Second fragment carries bytes 1400 to 2799, and the offset value for this fragment is 1400 by 8, which is 175. Third fragment carries bytes 2800 to 399. Offset value for this fragment is 2800 by 8, which is 350, which has been shown here. So you can see original datagram numbered from 0 to 3999. Then first fragment carries 0 to 1399. You can see here 0 to 1399. Second carries 1400 to 2799. Third carries 2800 to 399. Then offset value for first one is 0. Second is 175. Third one is 350. Okay, so it is 0 by 8 is 0. 1400 by 8, 175. 2800 by 8 is 350. Okay, so value of the offset is measured in units of 8 bytes. Length of the offset field is only 13 bits long and cannot represent a sequence of bytes greater than 819. So length of the offset field is only 13 bits long and cannot represent a sequence of bytes greater than 819. This forces hosts or routers that fragment datagrams to choose the size of each fragment so that the first byte number is divisible by 8. So there is a need to choose the size of each fragment so that the first byte number is divisible by 8. Then, so this diagram is representing the fragmentation example. Now we'll see with expanded view of the fragment in the previous figure. So this is the expanded view of the fragment in the previous figure. Original packets, you can see here original. Original packet starts at the client. You can see here. Original it has been written, no? Starts at the client. Fragments are reassembled at the server. You can see here. Reassembled. Fragments are reassembled at the server. Value of the identification field is same in all fragments as is the value of the flags field with more bits set for all fragments except the last. You can see here. Value of the identification field is same. You can see here. Same in all fragments. Here also you can see. You can see it is same. Here also you can see. You can see it is same here. Here also you can see. Value of the identification field is same in all fragments. You can see here, it is same here. You can see it is same in all the fragments as is the value of the flags filled with more bits set for all fragments except the value of the offset field for each fragment is shown. The fragments arrived out of order at the destination, they can be correctly reassembled. Even though they arrive out of order, but they can be reassembled correctly. So you can see fragment 1, fragment 2, fragment 3, fragment 2.1, fragment 2.2. Because 2 again fragments from fragment 2. So fragment 2 is again fragmented with number 2.1, 2.2. Even though if they arrive out of order, but they can be correctly reassembled. The value of the offset field for each fragment is shown. Then this all figure shows what happens if a fragment itself is fragmented. Then the value of the offset field is always, whatever is the value of the offset field is always relative to the original datagram. Okay, whatever is the original datagram with respect to that is the example. Second, so I told you, second fragment fragment 2 itself is again two fragments. Of one is of 800 bytes and another is of 600 bytes. So 1400 to 2199 is 800 bytes. 2200 to 2799 is 600 bytes. But the offset shows the relative position of the fragments to the original data. If each fragment follows a different path and arrives out of order, then whatever is the final destination host can reassemble the original datagram from the fragments received, even if none of, provided not even one has been lost, using following strategy. How it is reassembled, even though if they are out of order, if not one is lost, using this following strategy, it is followed. The first point is, the first fragment has an offset field value of 0. So the first fragment field, you can see, is always having offset field 000. Here it has been shown. No? It is here 000. You can see here 000. So the first fragment field has an offset value of 0. Second, divide the length of the first fragment by 8. Second fragment has an offset value equal to that result. So you can see here. Which has been divided by 8, then second fragment will have offset value equal to that result 175. Okay. Third one, divide the total length of the first and second fragment by 8. Third fragment has an offset value equal to that of the result. You can see the third fragment. So this process must be continued. The last fragment has its m bit set to 0. Again, continue the process. The last fragment has a more bit value of 0. You can see that. Okay. So this is regarding that. Next field is options. Next field is options. So whatever is the header of the IP version 4 datagram, it is made of two parts. Made of two parts. Made of two parts. The option header of the IP version 4 datagram is So you can see this header of the IP version 4 datagram is made of two parts, a fixed part and a variable part. The fixed part is 20 bytes long. The variable part compromises options that can be a maximum of 40 bytes to preserve the boundary of the header. Options, as the name implies, are not required for a datagram. They can be used for network testing and debugging. The options are particularly needed for network testing and debug. Options are not a required part of the IP version 4 header. Option processing is required of the IP version 4 software, meaning that all implementations must be able to handle options if they are present in the header. So options, single byte option, multiple byte option. You can see single byte option, multiple byte option. So we'll stop here and continue in the next lecture.